When you go online, you type in narcissist or recognizing narcissist or narcissistic abuse, or you type in anything related to narcissism, you'll get thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of results. Of course, you will never go through all those hundreds of thousands of results. But the main results that the search engine will reveal are often either packages to teach you how to recognize narcissists and how to deal with narcissists, or those are survival stories of people and how they manage to cope with narcissism and get away from a narcissist. Because it goes like this. You go through something in your life that's very disturbing, and you recognize it's very disturbing, but you can't put your finger on it, what's going on. So you look for help, and that's a healthy thing to do. So you go online, you find this subject called narcissism, and while you're reading about it, it is as if there are bells ringing in your head, and suddenly you have these aha moments that you recognize a lot of stuff. So what happens now is that because you feel validated, you want to know more and more and more. Okay, and until now, there's something wrong with this attitude, but here's where it gets sketchy. Here's where many are deceived. They are led to focus so much on the narcissist and what the narcissist did or didn't do that they lose perspective. And when you lose perspective, you are more deceived than you were when you didn't knew anything. Listen what I'm saying carefully. When you didn't knew anything, you thought you were deceived then. But when you lose perspective, because you only have knowledge about one area, and you're led away from seeing the bigger picture, you're deceived far more. Because when you knew nothing, you at least could wake up, realize you need to know stuff. But now that you're led in the direction in which you feel validated as if you know everything, while you miss bigger picture, that's dangerous. Because now you will make decisions based on false confidence that may lead to far worse consequences. Now look, it goes like this. Pagans know about narcissism far better than anyone else. And the pagan rulers of this world, they need to keep the human population in the negative, because that's how demons get their supply. So the human population, especially the human males, need to be in a negative state of mind so that they will emit negative energy so that demons can feed off of them. And when you have narcissists in your life, such people will cause you to become distressed. You don't want to become distressed, but they cause you to become distressed because such people are laden with toxic energy. So for you to recognize a narcissist for a narcissist, or to see the difference between someone that needs deliverance or someone you need to be delivered from, for you to get this insight is life-saving. But if many people got this insight, you wouldn't have many narcissists running around like crazy, doing a lot of stuff and getting away with it, because people would be alert. But the pagan rulers of this world don't want you to be alert in a life-saving manner. They want you to be alert to bring you in false confidence. They don't want you to be alert so you are operating in life-saving knowledge. They don't want that. Because if you would do that, you would begin to see through more stuff. You would begin to see through the matrix that the pagan rulers of this world are keeping intact. They want you, like a battery, to comply and supply to the matrix without you being aware of it. But they know that as a human being, you will notice things and you want answers. So they will provide you factual answers, but just enough answers to keep you trapped as a battery to the matrix. They want to drain all your life source, stealing your joy and natural happiness, so that you will keep seeking relief in the system. That is what the pagan rulers of this world want. This whole society and international structure is based on keeping people in the negative so that they will be like batteries to the matrix. Why? Because the pagan rulers of this world, they worship the beast. And that is what they do to sustain this beast system. You get what I'm saying here? So that's why I always tell you to look at the bigger picture. Okay, I'm going to give a parable now, as I often do, so that you will get a better idea of what I'm saying here. Let's say you have Bethany. Bethany met her husband in her last year of college. They married after she graduated, and they moved into their home. After 3 years of marriage, she noticed that the guy would often stay away from home for days. Now, her husband, Mark, was a businessman, so she thought, well, he may have to stay away for business, it's very important. So she was very supporting and all of that. Afterwards, she found out he was having an affair. She was heartbroken. She even began to ask how it was possible, because she always did her best for him. Of course, Mark denied everything, began to gaslight her. One day, Mark left completely. He just disappeared. And, well, Bethany had to leave the house because nobody was able to pay the mortgage, because Mark's income wasn't around anymore. So she went through an economic, I'd say a financial disaster, and she was depressed also. Then someone told her about narcissism, and when she began to read about narcissism, man, she it is as if light went on in her head. She understood completely what's going on. But here's where it gets tricky. Bethany now received a lot of tactics how to recognize narcissists, how to deal with people to prevent people from hurting her. That was her goal, to prevent something like that from happening again. But here's the thing. Bethany herself had an abandonment issue that developed during her youth. She didn't have a painful childhood, but she developed this unhealthy attachment style to her parents, because her parents weren't that well in parenting. And this unhealthy style of attaching to people also caused frustrations in her friendships. But because the frustrations weren't that big, she never thought about that there was something wrong with how she thought and how she felt about people. She never noticed it. And besides that, she was successful at a job and in college, so she thought, well, there's nothing wrong with her. But it's this unhealthy attachment style that blinded her from seeing the dangerous guy she was dealing with. So instead of her looking at the bigger picture and also evaluating her own thinking and her and all the people she encountered, she was now so focused on getting rid of the pain that Mark caused her, and so-called moving on with her life. But what happened now? She still had this unhealthy attachment style, but on top of that, she now learned which ways how to manipulate people to give her ease. She called it putting boundaries or speaking her mind. There were all kinds of other labels those tactics were given. But eventually it came down to, she was taught how to, well, cause people to give her whatever she wanted at all cost. So eventually she became to behave narcissistic, even though she was not aware of it. She just thought she was maintaining her boundaries and all of that. So after she realized that the way she interacted now worked far better than how she used to, she thought she made progress. She thought she improved. But no. Now she was the one exploiting people around her, and this made her more unhappy. But Mark was not around anymore. She was with another guy now. And this guy was so subservient, he went along with everything she wanted. Now, anyone who looks at the situation and looks at it objectively would say that Bethany is worse off now than when Mark left her. Because when Mark left her, she at least had a wake-up call that something wasn't right. But now, she's so built up in misplaced confidence that she can't even tell her anymore that she is heading in the wrong direction. Because the short-term benefits of what she has been taught by those worldly gurus blinded her from looking, from seeing the bigger picture and realizing she's trapped. Look, what I'm saying in this recording is the following. When bad stuff happens, you recognize it. But don't just focus on the bad stuff. Or better said, don't just focus on getting away or forgetting or leaving behind the bad stuff, because that's what a lot of people do. When bad stuff happens, you just want to get rid of it. You just want to relieve from it. Of course, if something is bad, you want to get rid of it. That's natural. But don't put too much focus on getting rid of the bad or forgetting the bad or moving away from the bad. If something bad happens, it happens. Okay, it happened. Look beyond what happened, so you will get a bit better view of what's going on. But that is what a lot of folks just don't do. And because they don't do this, they lose perspective. And they go from bad to worse. And here's the way Satan operates and those evil spirits, and they use people for this. When the enemy sees you're in a bad and you want to get away from the bad, he often leads you to worse. But between you leaving the bad and arriving at the worse, there's a space of relief in which things so-called work out. And because in this space of relief things so-called work out, you're blinded from looking beyond. So again, learn to look at the bigger picture. Don't just take things at face value. See true stuff. Well, that's it for now. Agree with Christ and be at peace.